Show. Starring Lucille Ball. Co-starring Gail Gordon.
Look like 39 stories to me. Oh, everything's slowing up right here. Mr. Winslow! Mr. Winslow!
Good morning, Mr. Mooney. What can I do?
Mr. Winslow, things aren't going zip, zip, zip around here.
Don't you worry, Mr. Mooney. We may have to work around the clock, but we'll get this building up in time.
Oh, fine, fine, fine. Good, good. You don't mind if I hang around a while, do you?
Why, you go right ahead. After all, your bank owns this project as much as I do.
Yeah, well, a little more if you count the interest.
Always count the interest. That's very...
Good heavens! Somebody's wasting a nail.
It is... bent, Mr. Mooney.
Well, couldn't you use it on a corner?
All right, we'll try.
Well, fine. Now, I don't want to appear bossy, Mr. Winslow, but we're in this together. You leaning over your blueprints, the men leaning over their shovels, and me leaning over my checkbook.
You know something, you bankers are the unsung heroes. I think when we dedicate this building, we'll put your picture in the paper.
My picture in
sure,
the paper?
Us. Oh, my... You want to check this?
Excuse me.
Yes, indeed, indeed. My picture in the paper. Oh, I wonder if I should... Money is here.
Well, if you're burying it, they'll catch you.
Mrs. Carmichael, don't toy with me while I have a sharp shovel in my hand. Now, how did you find me?
Well, I went to the bank and they said they didn't know where you were and when you left or if you'd ever come back.
That's the message I always leave for you and my wife.
Finally, the bank guard told me where you were.
Why, that stool pigeon. All right, Mr. Carmichael, what is it that's so important that you had to come looking for me?
Well, I received my monthly allowance check, and it seems that there was a little mistake made.
My bank never makes mistakes.
But, Mr. Mooney...
Mrs. Carmichael, we have all the latest electronic equipment. We have electric adding machines, electric typewriters, and electric computers. It is impossible for us to make a mistake.
Oh, well, in that case, then I'll keep the extra $50 you sent me.
Oh, they must have blown a fuse.
Watch yourself, little lady. You feeling all right, ma'am?
I never felt better.
I'll tell that man not to be in such a hurry. We've got plenty of beautiful buildings in this town, but we don't want to lose any beautiful ladies.
Oh, thank you.
Ma'am, you need somebody to look out for you.
And for the building.
You're feeling all right.
Well, say something.
I'm not married.
Mr. Mooney, this little lady and I have been thrown together a lot. Don't you think it's about time that you introduced us?
Well, all right, but remember, you asked for it. This is Frank Winslow, who has to hurry and finish a building. This is Lucille Carmichael, who was just leaving.
How do you do?
Pleasure to meet you, Miss Carmichael. Say, it's a shame that you've got to rush off. I'd sure like to show you around the project a little.
Oh, well, I just love big, tall, handsome projects. I do happen to have a few minutes.
Oh, we're going to show you around the project. Better put this on. We certainly don't want anything to fall on that pretty head, do we, Mr. Mooney?
No.
No.
How do I look?
Like Sergeant York.
Oh. He's just spoofing you, ma'am. Why, it looks a darn sight cuter on you than it does on the fellas.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, boss, you want to check this foundation?
Be right there.
Now, look, Mr. Winslow doesn't have time today to take you on a guided tour.
Oh, well, it does look like everybody wants you.
Doggone it, I hate to renege on my invitation, Miss Carmichael, but you can see things are a little hectic here right now. Yeah. I tell you what, you have lunch with me tomorrow?
Lunch?
Well, I know it's kind of rushing things, but things are rushing me.
Well, I...
Mr. Mooney will vouch for me.
Well, he does have an A1 credit rating.
Boss, can I see you a minute?
Okay. Please, I'd sure be honored.
Make up your mind! You're holding up a 39-story building!
All right.
Oh, that's wonderful. See you at lunchtime tomorrow.
Okay. Gee! He's so rugged and tall.
Yes, reminds me of my younger days.
You look like that?
No, my wife did.
Luncheon date. I'm gonna need a new dress. Mr. Mooney, you know that $50 that I just gave back to you?
What $50?
Oh, come on now, Mr. Mooney. Come on,
I'm gonna
have to borrow it.
Oh,
just a little.
Oh, man. Go!
Go! I like it up here. High up like this is gives me a happy feeling.
Gosh, Lucy, it's just wonderful the way you're taking this. You know, I had reservations for lunch at a real swanky restaurant, and then my foreman didn't come to work this morning, and, well, I had to stay here.
Oh, is your foreman sick?
Oh, no. He got hired to do one of those cigarette commercials.
Oh, a cigarette commercial. Oh, was he going to have a black eye, or is he going to get indigestion from eating his hat?
See, let's stand up here and take a look around.
Stand up and take a look around?
Why, sure.
Well, I can see fine sitting down, Frank.
Oh, come on. Here, I'll help you. Yes, take it easy.
Yeah.
That's the time. Slow and easy. Atta girl. Well, that's fine. Nothing to it.
No, I like it up here.
You know something, Lucy?
What?
When this building is finished, this whole floor is going to be a penthouse restaurant.
Oh?
And just think, we're the first ones to eat here.
Oh, goody. I always do ask for a table by the window, but this is the first time I ever got a table out the window.
You know, a person needs breathing room.
Yeah?
I come up here sometimes just to think.
You come up here to think? Yeah, well, I could do a lot of thinking up here, too, but mostly about falling.
Oh, you want to go back down, Lucy?
No, I don't want to go back down. I was just kidding. Ha, ha, ha. But I would like to sit down, Frank.
Oh, well, certainly.
Oh.
Well, just take it slow and easy.
Oh, all right.
At a time. So we can use this. Well, we'll have you hopping around here like a grasshopper in no time. Bye, Dolly. Bye. I almost forgot. I got a present for you.
You got me a present?
Yeah.
What is it?
Hey, Harry, where's that box?
It's on the way up.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping maybe you'd be paying us regular visits here.
Up here?
Yeah. So, I got something for you.
Oh, how nice.
There you are. My riveter make it up special for you.
Riveter made it? Oh. It's got my name on it and everything. I just love it, Frank.
Oh, that's wonderful. Let's drink to that.
Oh, you got champagne, too?
Sure.
Well.
We'll drink to having our heads in the clouds.
Having our heads in the clouds. That's not... You know, it's just like having a picnic.
But you don't have to worry about the ants.
No, just the birds.
Say, Lucy, you know, it's been a long time since I met somebody like you.
Oh, go on. You must have a lot of girlfriends.
Say, I got a wonderful idea.
What?
Why don't I take you dining and dancing Saturday night?
Saturday night? Well...
Ah, come on.
Well,
I won't take no for an answer.
Well, how can I resist a man on a girder?
The whistle. Lunch hour's over.
Oh, you fellas don't go in for those little dinner bells, do you?
Now, if we'd have had a little dinner bell, you wouldn't be in my arms right now.
All right, you lovebirds, get off the perch. Lunch hour's over.
If I don't pop out first. Ooh, that smells delicious.
Thanks for letting me use your oven, Lucy. I'm going to have to get a bigger oven or fewer relatives.
Oh, do your relatives come to visit you very often?
No, once a year is all I can stand.
You mean they don't come to see you on Christmas and Thanksgiving?
And ruin a holiday? And I guess we'll have our usual fight about carving.
You fight about carving?
Everybody wants to carve the turkey, and I don't trust any of my relatives with a knife.
Jane. Boy, that looks delicious, and I'm just starving.
You want a nibble?
No, no, I don't want to spoil my appetite. Frank says that we're going to have a real elegant dinner tonight.
Oh, Lucy, this Frank sounds absolutely marvelous. What's he like?
Well, I really don't know him very well, but the little bit that I know is very nice.
Now, what does he look like?
He's very tall, and, well, he looks like the Washington Monument with a suntan.
Gee, are you lucky. My boyfriend's built like the Liberty Bell. Come to think of it, he's even a little cracked. You sure you don't want some of this breakfast?
No, don't tempt me.
Mary Jane, where are your other television sets?
I only have one.
One television set? Fine hostess you are. My screaming kids have got to watch other screaming kids twitching on TV, so I got to miss the wrestling matches. One TV set. Thanks a lot, Mary Jane.
Who was that?
My Aunt Gussie. She's the nicest one in the family.
Oh, boy. That must be Frank. Oh, do you want to meet him, Mary Jane?
I better not. Once you've looked at the Washington Monument, it's tough going out with the Liberty Bell. I'll get the turkey after you go.
Okay.
Oh,
in.
Hi, Lucy. Gosh, you sure look pretty.
Well, you look a little different yourself. Why don't you sit down for a minute and I'll get my things.
Oh, I'd be afraid to.
Afraid to sit down? My divan is a lot safer than your steel girder.
No, it's just that I'm a little tired tonight. I worked 48 hours straight, and if I sit down, I might not get up again.
Say, look, maybe you could just take a 10-minute nap, and then I'll wake you up.
Oh, no, don't ever do that, Lucy.
Don't ever do what?
Wake me.
Why not?
Well, during the war, I was a commando, and I learned karate, and when somebody wakes me up sudden, like, I start swinging.
Oh, well, say, you must crack up a lot of alarm clocks.
No, but I did break my brother's nose once.
Oh, no. Yeah. Oh, that's terrible.
What do you say we get out of here? I'm hungry.
Oh, me too. I'm starving. I'll only be a minute.
Oh, gosh, I'm sorry, Lucy.
Oh, was that karate?
It was like I told you. That's what happens when somebody wakes me up.
Well, gee, I didn't even know you were asleep.
I'm awful sorry. I'll have it fixed. Don't worry about it.
Oh, that's all right. That's all right. I kind of like it that way.
I just hope I didn't scare you.
No, I'm all right. But, you know, Frank, I'm worried about you. Now, look. You better rest a while. You just come on over here now. I insist.
Well, I'll just sit down a minute. I won't go to sleep.
All right. I think that makes a lot of sense. Now, I think it's a shame that you have to work so hard. Mr. Mooney's nothing but an old slave driver. 48 hours without sleep. What does he think you are, a machine? Person can't go 48 hours without sleep. You know what you ought to tell him, Frank? You just ought to walk up to him and you say, Miss Frank. Frank. Oh, Frank. Frank, are you asleep?
Boy, you're a big one.
Yeah.
Now I've got the hiccups. I always get them when I'm hungry. Smell of that turkey's been driving me crazy.
Well, Lucy, why is he sleeping?
I'll explain later. Help me get rid of these hiccups before they wake him.
Well, why shouldn't we wake him up?
Because he learned karate in the commandos. He worked 48 hours, and if you wake him up, he'll break your brother's nose.
I haven't got a brother. How about my Aunt Gussie?
Please stop asking questions. Miss Jims, help me get rid of these hiccups.
Oh, I know a cure. A paper bag on your head. Have you got a paper bag?
Yeah, hurry up. By the refrigerator. Scared him out of me.
Aunt Gussie just drives me crazy.
Well, you're taking your turkey away.
A little piece, Lucy.
Yeah, sure would. Just give me a little bite. Just.
Oh. Gosh, I'm sorry.
Well, you won't have to worry about who carves this year. Well, that's all right, Frank. Don't you be sorry. I want you to meet my friend Mary Jane Lewis.
Oh, hi.
How do you do?
My hand's all greasy.
Oh, well, it's nice meeting you, Mr. Monument. I'll be going now, Lucy.
I hope your Aunt Gussie likes turkey hash.
Yes, I...
How long have I been asleep?
Oh, not very long, but you were so tired, Frank.
Well, I feel fresh and raring to go now.
Okay, we'll go. The evening's still young yet.
Sure.
Okay. Come on.
Ah, there you are. I've just come from the construction site and things are slowing down.
I demand that you return to the job immediately.
Mr. Mooney, I promised to take this lady out to dinner. I've caused her nothing but trouble all evening long. And I practically wrecked her whole house.
You've wrecked her house?
With one hand.
With one hand? Well, if you're going, why don't you get going?
Use my credit card. Take my card right outside.
I'm not married.
Mr. Mooney, this little lady and I have been thrown together a lot. Don't you think it's about time that you introduced us?
Well, all right, but remember, you asked for it. This is Frank Winslow, who has to hurry and finish a building. This is Lucille Carmichael, who was just leaving.
How do you do?
Pleasure to meet you, Miss Carmichael. Say, it's a shame that you've got to rush off. I'd sure like to show you around the project a little.
Oh, well, I just love big, tall, handsome projects. I do happen to have a few minutes.
Oh, we're going to show you around the project. Better put this on. We certainly don't want anything to fall on that pretty head, do we, Mr. Mooney?
No. No.
How do I look?
Like Sergeant York.
Oh, he's just spoofing you, ma'am. Why, it looks a darn sight cuter on you than it does on the fellas.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, boss, you want to check this foundation?
Be right there.
Now, look, Mr. Winslow doesn't have time today to take you on a guided tour.
Oh, well, it does look like everybody wants you.
Doggone it, I hate to renege on my invitation, Miss Carmichael, but you can see things are a little hectic here right now. Yeah. I tell you what, you have lunch with me tomorrow?
Lunch?
Well, I know it's kind of rushing things, but things are rushing me.
Well, I...
Mr. Mooney will vouch for me.
Well, he does have an A1 credit rating.
Boss, can I see you a minute?
Okay. Please, I'd sure be honored.
Well...
Make up your mind! You're holding up a 39-story building!
All right.
Oh, that's wonderful. See you at lunchtime tomorrow.
Okay. Gee! He's so rugged and tall.
Yes, reminds me of my younger days.
You look like that?
No, my wife did.
Gee, a luncheon date. I'm going to need a new dress. Mr. Mooney, you know that $50 that I just gave back to you?
What $50?
Oh, come on now, Mr. Mooney. Come on,
well,
I'm going to have to borrow it.
Oh,
just a
moment. Go! Go!
I like it up here. High up like this is gives me a happy feeling.
Well, gosh, Lucy, it's just wonderful the way you're taking this. You know, I had reservations for lunch at a real swanky restaurant, and then my foreman didn't come to work this morning, and, well, I had to stay here.
Oh, is your foreman sick?
Oh, no. He got hired to do one of those cigarette commercials.
Oh, a cigarette commercial. Oh, was he going to have a black eye or is he going to get indigestion from eating his hat?
See, let's stand up here and take a look around.
Stand up and take a look around?
Why, sure.
Well, I can see fine sitting down, Frank.
Oh, come on. Here, I'll help you. Yes, take it easy.
Yeah.
That's a fine, slow and easy. Atta girl. Well, that's fine. Nothing to it.
No, I...
Oh, gosh, I'm sorry, Lucy.
Was that karate?
It was like I told you. That's what happens when somebody wakes me up.
Well, gee, I didn't even know you were asleep.
I'm awful sorry. I'll have it fixed. Don't worry about it.
Oh, that's all right. That's all right. I kind of like it that way.
I just hope I didn't scare you.
No, I'm all right. But, you know, Frank, I'm worried about you. Now, look, you better rest a while. You just come on over here. Now, I insist.
Well, I'll just sit down a minute. I won't go to sleep.
All right. I think that makes a lot of sense. Now, I think it's a shame that you have to work so hard. Mr. Mooney's nothing but an old slave driver. 48 hours without sleep. What does he think you are, a machine? A person can't go 48 hours without sleep. You know what you ought to tell him, Frank? You just ought to walk up to him and you say, Miss Frank. Frank. Oh, Frank. Frank, are you asleep? When I'm hungry. Smell of that turkey's been driving me crazy.
Well, Lucy, why is he sleeping?
I'll explain later. Help me get rid of these hiccups before they wake him.
Well, why shouldn't we wake him up?
Because he learned karate in the commandos. I get up here.
You know something, Lucy?
What?
When this building is finished, this whole floor is going to be a penthouse restaurant.
Oh?
And just think, we're the first ones to eat here.
Oh, goody. I always do ask for a table by the window, but this is the first time I ever got a table out the window.
You know, a person needs breathing room.
Yeah?
I come up here sometimes just to think.
You come up here to think? Yeah, well, I could do a lot of thinking up here, too, but mostly about falling.
Oh, you want to go back down, Lucy?
No, I don't want to go back down. I was just kidding. Ha, ha, ha. But I would like to sit down, Frank.
Oh, well, certainly.
Oh.
Just take it slow and easy.
Oh, all right.
At a time. I will have you hopping around here like a grasshopper in no time. Bye, Dolly. I almost forgot. I got a present for you.
You got me a present?
Yeah.
What is it?
Hey, Harry, where's that box?
It's on the way up.
Yeah, I was
was kind of hoping maybe you'd be paying us regular visits here.
Up here?
Yeah. So, I got something for you.
Oh, how nice.
There you are.
Oh, Frank. Oh, it's beautiful.
I had my riveter make it up special for you.
Riveter made it? Oh. It's got my name on it and everything. I just love it, Frank.
Oh, that's wonderful. Let's drink to that.
Oh, you got champagne, too?
Sure.
Well.
We'll drink to having our heads in the clouds.
Having our heads in the clouds. That's nice. You know, it's just like having a picnic.
But you don't have to worry about the ants.
No, just the birds.
Say, Lucy, you know, it's been a long time since I met somebody like you.
Oh, go on. You must have a lot of girlfriends.
Say, I got a wonderful idea.
What?
Why don't I take you dining and dancing Saturday night?
Saturday night? Well.
Ah, come on.
Well,
I won't take no for an answer.
Well, how can I resist a man on a girder?
The whistle. Lunch hour's over.
Oh, you fellas don't go in for those little dinner bells, do you?
Now, if we'd have had a little dinner bell, you wouldn't be in my arms right now.
All right, you lovebirds, get off the perch. Lunch hour's over.
Like 39 stories to me.
Oh, everything's slowing up right here.
Mr. Winslow! Mr. Winslow!
Good morning, Mr. Mooney. What can I do?
Mr. Winslow, things aren't going zip, zip, zip around here.
Don't you worry, Mr. Mooney. We may have to work around the clock, but we'll get this building up in time.
Oh, fine, fine, fine. Good, good. You don't mind if I hang around a while, do you?
Why, you go right ahead. After all, your bank owns this project as much as I do.
Yeah, well, a little more if you count the interest.
Always count the interest. That's very...
Good heavens! Somebody's wasting a nail.
It is... bent, Mr. Mooney.
Well, couldn't you use it on a corner?
All right, we'll try.
Well, fine. Now, I don't want to appear bossy, Mr. Winslow, but we're in this together. You leaning over your blueprints, the men leaning over their shovels, and me leaning over my checkbook.
You know something, you bankers are the unsung heroes. I think when we dedicate this building, we'll put your picture in the paper.
My picture in
sure,
the paper?
Boss.
Oh, my...
You want to check this?
Excuse me.
Yes, indeed, indeed. My picture in the paper. Well, I wonder if I should...
Job at the bank.
What? I did not
lose my job at the bank. I'm here because the bank's money is here.
Well, if you're burying it, they'll catch you.
Just calm, Michael. Don't toy with me while I have a sharp shovel in my hand. Now, how did you find me?
Well, I went to the bank and they said they didn't know where you were and when you left or if you'd ever come back.
That's the message I always leave for you and my wife.
Finally, the bank guard told me where you were.
Why, that stool pigeon. All right, sit down, Michael. What is it that's so important that you had to come looking for me?
Well, I received my monthly allowance check, and it seems that there was a little mistake made.
My bank never makes mistakes.
But Mr. Mooney...
Mrs. Carmichael, we have all the latest electronic equipment. We have electric adding machines, electric typewriters, and electric computers. It is impossible for us to make a mistake.
Oh, well, in that case, then, I'll keep the extra $50 you sent me.
Oh, they must have blown a fuse.
Whoops. Watch yourself, little lady. You feeling all right, ma'am?
I never felt better.
I'll tell that man not to be in such a hurry. We've got plenty of beautiful buildings in this town, but we don't want to lose any beautiful ladies.
Oh, thank you.
Ma'am, you need somebody to look out for you.
And for the building.
You're feeling all right.
Well, say something.
Hi, Mary Jane.
Wow, what an outfit. Oh, that'll make their eyes pop out.
Thank you. If I don't pop out first. Oh, that smells delicious.
Thanks for letting me use your oven, Lucy. I'm going to have to get a bigger oven or fewer relatives.
Oh, do your relatives come to visit you very often?
No, once a year is all I can stand.
You mean they don't come to see you on Christmas and Thanksgiving?
And ruin a holiday? And I guess we'll have our usual fight about carving.
You fight about carving?
Everybody wants to carve the turkey, and I don't trust any of my relatives with a knife.
Jane, boy, that looks delicious, and I'm just starving.
You want a nibble?
No, I don't want to spoil my appetite. Frank says that we're going to have a real elegant dinner tonight.
Oh, Lucy, this Frank sounds absolutely marvelous. What's he like?
Well, I really don't know him very well, but the little bit that I know is very nice.
Now, what does he look like?
He's very tall, and, well, he looks like the Washington Monument with a suntan.
Gee, are you lucky. My boyfriend's built like the Liberty Bell. Come to think of it, he's even a little cracked. You sure you don't want some of his bright fiddle?
No, don't tempt me.
Mary Jane, where are your other television sets?
I only have one.
One television set? Fine hostess you are. My screaming kids have got to watch other screaming kids twitching on TV, so I got to miss the wrestling matches. One TV set. Thanks a lot, Mary Jane.
Who was that?
My Aunt Gussie. She's the nicest one in the family.
Oh, boy. That must be Frank. Oh, do you want to meet him, Mary Jane?
I better not. Once you've looked at the Washington Monument, it's tough going out with the Liberty Bell. I'll get the turkey after you go.
Okay. Hi, Frank. Come on in.
Hi, Lucy. Gosh, you sure look pretty.
Well, you look a little different yourself. Why don't you sit down for a minute and I'll get my things.
Oh, I'd be afraid to.
Afraid to sit down? My divan is a lot safer than your steel girder.
No, it's just that I'm a little tired tonight. I worked 48 hours straight, and if I sit down, I might not get up again.
Say, look, maybe you could just take a 10-minute nap, and then I'll wake you up.
Oh, no, don't ever do that, Lucy.
Don't ever do what?
Wake me.
Why not?
Well, during the war, I was a commando, and I learned karate, and when somebody wakes me up sudden, like, I start swinging.
Oh. Well, say, you must crack up a lot of alarm clocks.
No, but I did break my brother's nose once.
Oh, no. Yeah. Oh, that's terrible.
What do you say we get out of here? I'm hungry.
Oh, me too. I'm starving. I'll only be a minute.
Doesn't look like 39 stories to me.
Oh, everything's slowing up right here.
Mr. Winslow! Mr. Winslow!
Good morning, Mr. Mooney. What can I do?
Mr. Winslow, things aren't going zip, zip, zip around here.
Don't you worry, Mr. Mooney. We may have to work around the clock, but we'll get this building up in time.
Oh, fine, fine, fine. Good, good. You don't mind if I hang around a while, do you?
Why, you go right ahead. After all, your bank owns this project as much as I do.
Yeah, well, a little more if you count the interest.
Always count the interest. That's very...
Good heavens! Somebody's wasting a nail.
It is... bent, Mr. Mooney.
Well, couldn't you use it on the corner?
Finally, the bank guard told me where you were.
Why, that stool pigeon. All right, Mr. Carmichael, what is it that's so important that you had to come looking for me?
Well, I received my monthly allowance check, and it seems that there was a little mistake made.
My bank never makes mistakes.
But, Mr. Mooney...
Mrs. Carmichael, we have all the latest electronic equipment. We have electric adding machines, electric typewriters, and electric computers. It is impossible for us to make a mistake.
Oh, well, in that case, then, I'll keep the extra $50 you sent me.
Oh, they must have blown a fuse.
Watch yourself, little lady. You feeling all right, ma'am?
I never felt better.
I'll tell that man not to be in such a hurry. We've got plenty of beautiful buildings in this town, but we don't want to lose any beautiful ladies.
Oh, thank you.
Ma'am, you need somebody to look out for you.
And for the building.
You're feeling all right.
Well, say something.
I'm not married.
Mr. Mooney, this little lady and I have been thrown together a lot. Don't you think it's about time that you introduced us?
Well, all right, but remember, you asked for it.
This is Frank Winslow, who has to hurry and finish a building. This is Lucille Carmichael, who is just leaving.
How do you do?
Pleasure to meet you, Miss Carmichael. Say, it's a shame that you've got to rush off. I'd sure like to show you around the project a little.
Oh, well, I just love big, tall, handsome projects. I do happen to have a few minutes.
Oh, we're going to show you around the project. Better put this on. We certainly don't want anything to fall on that pretty head, do we, Mr. Mooney?
No. No. No.
Like
Sergeant York.
Boy. He's just spoofing you, man.
ma'am. Why, it looks a darn sight cuter on you than it does on the fellas.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, boss, you going to check this foundation?
Be right there.
Now, look, Mr. Winslow doesn't have time today to take you on a guided tour.
Oh, well, it does look like everybody wants you.
Doggone it, I hate to renege on my invitation, Miss Carmichael, but you can see things are a little hectic here right now. Yeah. I tell you what, you have lunch with me tomorrow?
Lunch?
Well, I know it's kind of rushing things, but things are rushing me.
Well, I...
Mr. Mooney will vouch for me.
Well, he does have an A1 credit rating.
Boss, can I see you a minute?
Okay. Please, I'd sure be honored.
Well...
Make up your mind! You're holding up a 39-story building!
All right.
Oh, that's wonderful. See you at lunchtime tomorrow.
Okay. Gee, he's so rugged and tall.
Yes, reminds me of my younger days.
You look like that?
No, my wife did.
Gee, a luncheon date. I'm gonna need a new dress. Mr. Mooney, you know that $50 that I just gave back to you?
What $50?
Oh, come on now, Mr. Mooney. Come on,
I have no idea.
Oh, just a
moment.
Gosh, Lucy, it's just wonderful the way you've taken this. You know, I had reservations for... All right, we'll try.
Well, fine. Now, I don't want to appear bossy, Mr. Winslow, but we're in this together. You leaning over your blueprints, the men leaning over their shovels, and me leaning over my checkbook.
You know something, you bankers are the unsung heroes. I think when we dedicate this building, we'll put your picture in the paper.
My picture in
sure,
the paper?
Boss. Oh, my... You want to check this?
Excuse me.
Yes, indeed, indeed. My picture in the paper. Well, I wonder if I should...
Sharp shovel in my hand. Now, how did you find me?
Well, I went to the bank and they said they didn't know where you were and when you left or if you'd ever come back.
That's the message I always leave for you and my wife.